Wouldn't it be great if all your devices could sound better? That's what AfterMaster does, and I'm here with the CEO of AfterMaster, Larry Rickman. So why don't you tell us, how did this come about and what does it do?
Josh, I've been in the audio technology industry for a very long time, and this was born out of a group of people from the music industry that wanted to make audio sound great again. This new generation has grown up with digital audio, which is flat. We make it deep, we make it full, we make it loud, and we're here because we have partnered up with a multi-billion dollar semiconductor company that's taken our technology, put it onto a chip that's going to go into millions of consumer devices very soon.
So the chip can go into televisions, stereos, all sorts of devices. And so how does the technology actually work to make the sound richer?
You know, I can't give you the secret sauce, but I will say this. It's the first technology that actually affects all of the audio event. So an event can be a song, an event can be a TV show, an event can be anything. It can be a walkie-talkie. It takes that audio event and treats it throughout the full frequency range. You know, you buy a pair of headphones, it's got lots of bass, but you lose something on the top end. You buy a TV, you turn on an enhancer, which most of us end up turning off. It's because it changes the underlying audio. We take that audio signal, we pull it apart, and we reconstruct every single piece of it and make it sound like it used to in the good old days.
How does it know what sounds better or what sounds more authentic?
It's a really good question. This is the first company that has attacked this with industry people involved. Shelly Yakis, one of my founding partners, has engineered more platinum albums than anybody in history. John Lennon, Tom Petty, U2, Bruce, Madonna. I've got my own mastering credits. These are people that have made hit records over many, many years. So we think it sounds better, and we think the public's going to think it sounds better.
Okay, I still don't understand how it works, and I'm not going to let you off the hook on that one. You're going to have to explain. How does it know what parts is better? Do you know all these people with great ears teach the algorithm, or is okay. There how does it know if a piece of bass is too flat and needs to be thicker?
Every other process is either you got big bass, you got a better high end, you got a better vocal, but something else gets hurt. And if you're going to ask for more secret sauce, I'm not going to give it to you.
All right, so we got a master of dodging my questions over here. So I'm not going to really listen to what he said. We're just going to put it in our ears and we'll see how it works.
Perfect. You got it.
So now we're going to listen to AfterMaster. It's going to play on a television, and there's specific device settings that AfterMaster designs for each different piece of hardware, but then you can play any bit of music or TV content through it, and it's supposed to sound better. So let's give it a shot. Why don't you play me this Justin Timberlake show or concert video without the mastering? So there's kind of like a muddiness in the mid to high end. It sounds kind of empty and echoey, like it's in a big hall, but it not with like a good acoustics that you might get from like a real, like a symphony hall. All right, so now why don't you play it with the after mastering. So it definitely sounds louder, which I think probably makes everything sound a little bit better. But it definitely sounds like there's more differentiation between the different parts of the song. You lose a lot of that echoiness that makes it feel like you're in an empty giant event hall. I get that Justin Timberlake is now an owner of this company. What does that mean?
He's a co-owner of this company. We don't pay Justin. Justin's in this because he believes that this can change audio on a worldwide basis. We found what we think is the secret. We think this is going to be a game changer for audio across the board. And what he can bring is some amazing relationships.
So how does this get into the hands of consumers? Are you guys getting this baked into a bunch of new devices? How can I get a hold of this kind of audio for my ears?
We have this little tiny digital signal processing microchip that can go into any hardware product with our partners on Semiconductor. They're a multi-billion dollar chip company.
Do I just glue it in or something? Or how do I put it?
That's why we're at CES, to partner with some big electronics companies to take our technology, these little chips, and put it into things like, it could be in this microphone, it could be in that camera, it could be in this computer, it could be in that TV. That microchip can fit into anything as small as a hearing aid.
Awesome. Well, thank you for showing us this cool technology. Definitely better than the standard audio we were getting out of the soundbar. So thanks a lot.
Perfect.